about your flying machine.
Brain power
makes you thoroughly unique.
With the power to think,
you can love anything.
Brain power. 100 billion neurons.
Hey, you got a lot of nerves.
Got their own communication.
Transmitting information. It's
electrical. Juan, I have a headache. Can you give me something to make it go away?
I can't give you anything, Julia. You should only take medicines from adults you trust, like your mom or your school nurse. You should have taken some before you came here.
Hi.
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 You don't look so well, Julia.
Headache.
Aww.
Sorry to hear about Julia's brain pain, but I'm gonna take your mind off it. I've got a mission for you. Remember how you learned some ways to keep your brain healthy?
Sure, like protecting our heads with helmets when we ride bikes.
And getting enough exercise.
Getting enough sleep.
Eating right.
You've got it. And the last thing was not to smoke cigarettes or drink alcohol.
Right.
Well, that leads us to some things you can do to keep your brain safe. I hope you junior scientists are ready to do some research, because this calls for learning about harmful drugs and helpful medicines. And I'm looking to you, Juan and Beth, to lead the way. Your first assignment is to answer this question. What are two helpful substances, and how should they be used?
Let's see, Dr. Juan. Helpful substances would stop pain, like Julia's headache. And I think aspirin is just what the doctor ordered.
I agree, Dr. Beth. That reminds me of another helpful medicine. Antibiotics are used to fight infections.
Well, that wasn't hard. Helpful medicines can be antibiotics or aspirin. They can make you feel better if you have an infection or a headache, but you should only take them from an adult you trust.
Good work, doctors. Now that wasn't much of a strain on your brains. But I have another question for you. Name two harmful substances and why they can hurt you.
I know that cigarettes are very harmful. There's a chemical in cigarettes called nicotine. Nicotine changes a person's brain and causes them to keep smoking. When a person keeps smoking, they cough and badly damage their lungs. And since we need our lungs to breathe, if they aren't healthy, it's hard to run and play.
Here's something else that isn't good for kids. Alcohol, like wine and beer, they make you feel dizzy and it hurts your brain.
Hey, so that means not drinking alcohol is one way to keep your brain safe.
Bingo! You're an excellent junior scientist, Julia. You're right. Drinking alcohol can be unsafe for your brain. But let's keep our thinking caps on, because this next question is a hard one. Which of the substances we talked about can be both a harmful drug and a helpful medicine? You work on that, and I'll be back.
Well, we know cigarettes are always bad.
My dad drinks beer sometimes, and I don't think it hurts him.
Alcohol can be okay for adults in small amounts, so it isn't always a harmful drug, but it isn't a helpful medicine either, so out it goes.
I've got it. Maybe helpful medicines like aspirin and antibiotics can be harmful if you take too much of them. That's why we have to take them from a responsible adult. Like a parent.
Good thinking, Juan. That's right. Taking too much of almost anything can be harmful to your body and your brain. Think about eating too much ice cream or cake.
So now we know that we have to keep our brains healthy, and we also have to keep them safe by protecting them from harmful substances.
Right, because now we know how important the brain is. It lets us think, play, breathe, and even sleep.
The brain is a really cool thing.
We can't live without it.
Now you're using your heads, and as a brain, I take that as a personal compliment. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Brain power.
Hey, talk about your fine machine.
Brain power.
Makes you thoroughly unique.
With the power to think.
You can learn anything.
Brain power. 100 billion neurons.
Hey, you got a lot of nerves.
Got their own communication.
Transmitting information.